In 1936, William Surion said, "I should like to see any power of the world destroy this race, this small tribe of unimportant people, whose wars have all been fought and lost, whose structures have crumbled, literature unread, music unheard, and prayers are no more answered. Go ahead, destroy Armenia. See if you can do it. Send them into the desert without bread or water and burn their homes and churches. And then see if they will not laugh, sing and pray again. For when two of them meet anywhere in the world, see if they will not create a new Armenia. There's no denying that there's evil in this world, but the light will always conquer the darkness. And I know that faith in God will not calm the storms of life, but it will calm my heart. As I develop faith into my life, I find that God supplies me with the strength and guidance that I need. My faith will shelter me, 'cause I believe." Growing up, I'd hear stories of the horrors that took place far away, too young to understand concepts of time, space and race that came with age. When I was faced with the fate of my ancestors, I began to trace, piecing together the story, becoming familiar. I couldn't figure how the human race could harbour so much hate, the pain of 1.5 million people, innocent and peaceful, forced from the lands for following the Bible, treated less than equal, herded off like cattle onto trains. What lay ahead of them? Unspeakable. Speaking of evil, here's the story of our struggle, a massacre unequaled. Generations marched to the desert. The idea was genocide, to erase them from time. Only a few survived. How could man be so evil to formulate and orchestrate such a despicable crime? The extermination of a nation at the cradle of civilization, brazen in its devastation, wiped out the population. Even the devil was so surprised with what he saw with his eyes, he got down on his knees and cried. April 24th, 1915, local leaders and the clergy forced to gather, rounded up and shot. Pregnant women shocked as a knife cut their stomachs up to stop their unborn babies' beating hearts. And that's just the start. Children tied to rocks, thrown off cliffs from high up top. My people's plight, set alight in caves, turned to mass graves. Satan won while the world sat and watched on. Souls taken, my tribe forsaken. For what? Wealth, power and greed of dirty politicians fulfilling selfish needs. The truth untold of a traumatized nation undergone systematic eradication. Well, Hitler said in 33, who after all speaks of their annihilation? Well, generations on we carry scars of our forefathers, small in numbers. We're still together, holier in number. But we remember, the smallest of seeds can grow into the greatest of trees. Even though a century on it never ends, young men are gone. They sacrificed their lives, defending their lands. And our wish is for man to understand their master plan. Until then, united in strength we'll stand. Devoted to build a prosperous future, we know never to forget that we're high till we die. Rest in peace to all those that we've lost.